You know what's the main problem with Google Calendar? It's the fact that I haven't had coffee and it's 5 a.m. That's my problem. That's not your problem. But what is an actual problem is the fact that people don't know these two really big tips that could change the way they work in Google Calendar forever. First and foremost, people ask me this question. Dimitri, how do you get Google Calendar to go from this to an actual application? And that's actually really simple. First, what you're going to do is you're going to go into Google Calendar and you're going to go to this if you're in Chrome. And then you're going to go to More Tools, Create Shortcut, tick this box, and press Create. And then bada bing, bada boom, you have a Google Calendar app. And as you can see, when I type it in the bottom left search bar, it'll pop up as Google Calendar. Now, something else that people don't know about Google Calendar that is a very recent addition is if you have the school or business version, you can actually do Calendly things. So if you click this right here and go to appointment schedule, what you'll see is there's actually different blocks that you can set for bookable appointment schedule. So let's pretend I actually have time between these different hours. Let's change the times a bit. 2 p.m., 2 p.m., 1, and then like 11 to 1, 1 p.m. to 3 p.m., stuff like this. So if I do this, you can change the color, you can add labels, you can set buffer time between things. I like to add like a 30-minute buffer time between things, or more like a 15-minute so that I can have back-to-backs. And then the scheduling window can be edited here. Then you go next, then bookable appointment schedule. Dimitri meeting times. All right. And then you can pick your booking page, photo, and name. And if you go to save, it's creating a booking page right now. And if I click on see all your appointment schedules, you'll see there's Dimitri meeting times. And if I click on that, it's got a completely Calendly-like thing scheduled. So if you're right here, Dimitri meeting times, and then you can book a time with that person. If I press book, you'll see Monday 12:30. If I go to my actual calendar really quick and I go to Rise Productive, I booked a time with myself. How cute is that? Then if you want to delete availability, so you can click on these different times, you can move these times for availability, and then you can delete just this week only, all weeks, or all availability. So I'm going to just delete all availability. And the reason I would recommend using this is if you want to stay lean as a company and you don't want to deal with all the different odds and ends. So like, for example, TidyCal is great and costs only a few bucks a month, or Calendly is great and you can get it for free, but the real nice features are on the premium version. TidyCal is great. You can get it for a lifetime purchase of like under $30. But if you're already paying for Google's business plan or school plan, I mean, just go with what they gave you and go with this video on how to improve your productivity even more.